5, 4. WBI 99.5 FM. You are listening to Rebel Diaz Radio, New York City Tri-State Area, worldwide on WBAI.org. Pope is here and just arrived today to Washington, D.C.
You heard about the little girl Sophie?
I did. I saw the video. I thought it was great. She straight bum rushed the Pope.
As a five-year-old.
She got carried by the security guards, but she didn't just say hello and take a picture and smile. She gave the Pope.
She had a mission.
A letter. She gave the Pope a letter.
And she made sure he got the letter.
Oh, yeah.
The yellow shirt.
Oh yeah, I seen that.
I expected the Pope to wear the yellow shirt.
I thought he was gonna put it on. But he didn't. He did receive the letter. You know what I mean? It was a nice photo op, but beyond that, it was, you know what I'm saying?
If Rogi could walk,
I would give him a no human being is illegal shirt to give
the Pope
tomorrow.
So interesting developments with the arrival of the Pope. And he arrived into Washington, D.C. today. He's gonna be here in New York City. And he also will be visiting the community of El Barrio, East Harlem. So we will be seeing the Pope in El Barrio. We're going to go and talk to the people and see also how they're receiving him.
Okay, he's getting ready to leave. Looks like he's heading to the door.
Tell us how you felt now seeing the Pope right down in Harlem.
I felt very overwhelmed. It got me a little teary. I felt very blessed.
If you could say something to the Pope, what would you say?
I would say, Pope, thank you for like changing our lives and stuff like that. And I want him to give me good luck and like that.
We drove all the way from upstate New York, Queensbury or Lake George to come down and see him.
Wow, and you saw him drive by in Harlem.
Yeah, he drove right out. You know, right by us. We're like 10 feet from the curb.
If you could say one thing to the Pope, if you could see him in person, what would you say?
Thank you for all your great works and keep working.
Alright, there you go. Tell us your name, my brother.
Tony.
Tony.
Papa Shack.
Alright, tell us how you feel about the Pope coming in your block, coming here in Harlem.
It was a little bit exciting, but then it was also like a little bit of a pain, but it was good. It's something that you don't never really see a lot or experience. So it was definitely great to experience that and have that feeling of him coming by. So
did you sell a lot of pineapples?
We did pretty good. So yeah, I can say thank you, Pope.
So excited, and I guess this was the best place to come and see it because this is a barrio where the real people is.
That's about
the way to work.
Okay.
And I came from work and I missed him just now.
You missed the Pope?
Yes.
You love him?
Yes, I do.
How you feel about the fact that he came to Harlem, New York?
I love him even more.
Excellent.
How you feel about that he came to Harlem, New York?
Excellent.
Okay.
He came here because we don't get that kind of publicity and opportunities for big people come through because the other biggers don't recognize us.
Okay.
I'm glad that he was here.
That's what's up.
And in my heart, he's a brother. I love you, Pope.
All right, y'all have a good one.
Oh, and he did a good damn job.
A Pope comes like every blue moon. It's rare to get a Pope coming here.
And if you could say one thing to the Pope, what would you say? If you could see him in person and touch him, what would you say?
I don't know.
What would you say if you could say something to the Pope in person?
You would say hi.
How do you feel about the Pope having come to your school?
I was excited. I'm like, wow, I'm so lucky to be one of the students getting to meet him.
How's your business been today?
It's been great.
So tell us about, y'all live over here?
Yes, we live right here.
Y'all live right here. So did you see the Pope today?
Yes.
All right, and you said what's up?
Yes.
What did he do? Did he wave?
He didn't really see us.
Yeah,
he was over there.
You guys drew all that stuff over there?
All the
pictures.
Yeah, for him.
Cool. And how were the lemonade sales?
They
They're very good.
And how is the lemonade?
Delicious.
I think I have to try some. I'm going to have to try some. Oh, this is the lemonade right here? It looks kind of like water a little bit.
It's not.
Okay, I'm going to believe you. Here you go. 50 cents for you. Lemonade for me. Cool. Thank you, guys. And if you guys, just a quick question. We're asking everybody in the area this. What, if you could say one thing to the Pope, what would you say?
Welcome to New York City.
Thank you.
I love you.
Thanks for coming, and I love you so much.
God bless you.
You're cool.
All right.
And you don't stop Rooftop Live. We in Santiago, Chile, rocking one of the illest DJs, one of the pioneers of Chilean hip-hop. His name is DJ Dacel, my brother. Thank you for joining us. Appreciate you, dog. Yo, we were just with you. Recién estuvimos contigo hace poco. Y nos contaste un poco sobre tu favorito productores. Nos mostraste los vinilos. Tú siendo pionero, en realidad, de lo que es el hip-hop acá en Chile. Esa experiencia de estar en el Estación Mapocho. Quiero escuchar algo un poco de eso, de cómo fueron esos días y cómo para ti eso es la esencia del hip hop.
Claro, bueno, yo le contaba a los muchachos rebeldías sobre un lugar que era Mapocho, que era un lugar donde se reunía toda la escena hip hop de los 90, 90 y estoy hablando del año 96 al 98 más o menos. No sé si soy un pionero, pero hay muchos DJs y otras personas que vienen de antes, ¿cachai? De los 80. Entonces nos juntábamos ahí en la Estación Mapocho y pucha, era increíble porque ahí conocí a toda la escena hip hop de Santiago en un solo lugar, ¿cachai? Gente del norte, del sur, este y oeste, ¿cachai? Entonces se reunían todos los sábados ahí DJs, b-boys, grafiteros, MC, haciendo freestyle, intercambiando música, libros, revistas, videos, VHS, cinta. Así uno lograba la información en esos años, así que como fue un pilar para mí ese lugar.
Ya sé que la producción, los scratches están subiendo de nivel, entonces cuéntame un poco lo que viene para adelante para DJ Dacel.
Bueno, seguir tocando con Ana, los más buscados. También estoy haciendo proyectos personales, un disco nuevo y también tengo un proyecto más ligado a la electrónica también, ¿cachai? Entonces estoy ahí haciendo varias cosas a futuro, ¿cachai? Un disco que va a salir ahora en septiembre, así que estoy bien emocionado por eso.
It's time for our wrap up. Let's give it everything we've got. Ready? Begin. Thank you.
Thank you.